Are you a Theros Limited Master? Show us your skills at GP Sacramento on January 17th to 19th, hosted by Channel Fireball and Cascade Games. Enjoy the increased GP prize structure as well as our many side events, including the Friday Night Bounty event where you can get paired against members of Team Channel Fireball. If you beat one of them, we'll bestow extra prizes upon you. It's like I always say, the only thing better than meeting LSV is beating LSV.
Channel Fireball, Magic the Gathering lovers and friends and of the game, Travis Wu here, and the first thing I want to say is I hope everyone had a great Thanksgiving. I hope everybody gorged and caved into some carnal delights of a feast around the table and had an opportunity to spend some time with family and loved ones and maybe play some Magic with someone you haven't played in a really long time or whatever. I just think Thanksgiving is a great time to express love and thanks. So thanks for everyone who watches, and I send out my energies. Anyways, topic of the day is this Modern Worldfire brew. First thing I'll say is this is the sixth consecutive evening that I've played with this deck. Sometimes I'll break it up at the draft or, you know, brew another deck or whatever, but if I really enjoy a deck, I can really play with it every night for at least a week without getting tired of it, you know, a couple hours a night. And I'll say, the deck's very cheap as well. So if you're looking for some kind of budget brew that is not going to get old immediately, I recommend this. It's good. And on top of that, it wins a decent amount of the time against any kind of deck. I don't think it's really a metagame breaker or anything like that, but it just has game on account of being a random deck. You just kill people turn three sometimes, or sometimes you do absolutely nothing. So that's the fun of it. It's just a gambly type deck that can take games off anyone in a hilarious fashion and is cheap. And there's some mind games involved. Okay, so let's talk about the main. Let's go ahead and separate these. And we'll get back to these. The idea is just to have kind of a mono-red storm deck. 19 mountains, I like the white-bordered basics, because they stand out. They're going to be rare one day, and I'm going to be laughing because I have all of them, and they're valuable. Anyways, it's really a Pyromancer Ascension deck. If we get an Ascension down early, whenever we cast an instant spell that has the same name in our graveyard, we get a counter, and once we have two, everything we do doubles. On everything we have makes mana or draw, so you can start. We can just draw through our whole deck and produce a bunch of mana if we're able to ever stick one of these. We've got 4 Faithless Looting, 4 Wild Guess, and 4 Reforge the Soul for 1 red, 2 red, or 3 in red, or sometimes 1 in red. We just can churn through cards to either find Ascension or put counters on Ascension once we're there. Or once we have Ascension, we just draw a bunch of cards. Now, we're powering this as well with Mana Morphos, which can draw 2. Just cuts through the deck real quick. Produces red, but, you know, it's good with an Ascension and activating Ascension. We have Pyretic and Desperate Rituals, so we have ways to make just buckets of mana, or little bits of mana to get our Ascension going, or power out, or reforge, or whatever. And then we have Past in Flames, because with all this drawing and discarding and mana production, we can use Past in Flames to draw even more cards from a card we discarded earlier in the turn. So that's basically what the deck is all about. And then, I mean, you can really kill from any way you want at that point. And this is where the humor element comes in. Flame Jab, Worldfire, and Spellweaver's Helix. Spellweaver's Helix is Imprint. When it enters the battlefield, we can exile 2 sorcery cards in our graveyard. Whenever a player casts a card, if it has the same name as one of the cards exiled with Spellweaver's Helix, you may copy the other and play without its cost. So if we split, if we have a Flame Jab and a Worldfire in our graveyard, and we play a Spellweaver Helix, and we may have discarded these from Wild Guest, Faithless Looting, or Reforge the Soul while churning through our deck, Spellweaver Helix, we can exile both of these. And then if we play Flame Jab, we get to copy Worldfire. If Flame Jab in our graveyard, we can retrace it, or we can just cast one. And Flame Jab, by the way, is pretty good at turning on Ascension if we get a second Flame Jab. Then when we play the Flame Jab, Worldfire happens, everything gets exiled, the opponent's at 1, Flame Jab finishes him off. Pretty hilarious, pretty fun. If you want to improve the main deck, this is not necessarily a good way to kill to win the most game ones, but I think it's a good sideboard strategy, which I'll get to. As for It's good for a match strategy, which I'll get to. As for actual numbers, you could go with three Worldfires, and three Helixes, as we only need two jabs and one of each to win, and we'll go through all of our deck, and you could fit another Passing Flames or something. But I think that this is the kind of deck that if we're gonna go big at all, we're gonna go super big and just be like, yo, we're gonna win from Worldfire as much as we possibly can. In order to do that, we need to play four of all the appropriate cards. So we're playing four. Makes sense? You can tune them down if you want. Now, the reason that I like this as a game one plan is because we play no creatures, and the opponent's like, all right, well, any kind of graveyard hate is going to hose them. Tormod's Crypt, Wailing of the Void, etc. So after board, we can board all these out, board in these, and now we have a deck that kills very fast with Young Pyromancer, Empty the Warrens, and Goblin Bushwhacker, and is all looting and such. And they probably boarded in Graveyard Hate, which does very little against us, and don't have boarded out their creature removal, sweepers and such, and then we get to steal all the wins off that. So if we ever pull off a game one win, we almost always win the match. The issue is that game one wins are tough to get because we're trying to kill them with this. So that's basically how the deck works. It's, again, it's fun. It's cheap. It continues to entertain, and it wins a little bit. So let's go ahead and play some matches, and you can see how it works. So let's do it.